Lung cancer is one of the leading cancer killers in this country. But in tonight's Health Alert, a new piece of equipment is making it less invasive for doctors to diagnose, treat, and hopefully destroy hard-to-reach tumors.
I was in for my breathing.
Okay.
And they took a CAT scan, and then they saw something in my lung.
35 years of smoking have taken their toll on George Vanegas. The 78-year-old Korean War vet has emphysema and one known lung cancer tumor. Now there's a second suspicious spot deep inside one of the small airways that branch out inside George's lungs.
With traditional bronchoscopy, we're limited by the size of the airways. We can't get beyond certain segments of the airways.
Dr. Eric Anderson is an interventional pulmonologist at Georgetown University Hospital who's using a new technology to get a better look inside patients' lungs.
As you can see us go all the way down inside the lungs.
Super Dimension, or Super D, is an electromagnetic tracking system, or GPS, for the lungs. It's used with a traditional bronchoscope to biopsy hard-to-reach nodules or masses.
Patients undergo a CAT scan with very high-resolution cuts. We take those images and we put them into the computer software and then generate a virtual bronchoscope, a virtual bronchoscopy of the airways, so that we can see where to go. We then plan where the nodule is that we're going after.
Once doctors get to that hard-to-reach mass, they can perform a biopsy to see if it really is cancer. In George's case, they're also placing tiny gold markers that will guide a radiation treatment called CyberKnife. It's George's best shot at cancer-fighting treatment, given his heart disease and emphysema.
When they go back with the CyberKnife now, we'll be able to see where the tumor is while we're treating the patient.
So one of the big risks with lung cancer treatment is that with the already fragile health of some of the patients, like George, the lungs can collapse. Using the Super D navigation system cuts down that risk a lot, and it's one of the reasons George's doctors referred him to Georgetown. Thanks for joining us for 9 News Now at 5. 9 News Now at 6 starts right now.